It's gonna be super long, so please bear with me. Alright, hi guys, welcome back to my wig tutorial. First thing first, what you need is your handy dandy wig, whatever it's called, mannequin. Just a two-piece wig stocking cap. And this is probably my new go-to wig making cap because it stays stretchy no matter how many times you wash it or wear it, unlike the elastic band one that stretches out and then you end up having to use a band. You don't have to do that with this. So what I usually start with always is the frontal. So this is the frontal. I have not customized it just yet. This is basically how it came out after I dyed it. There is some dye on the lace from where I kind of use my hands, but other than that, it's pretty much, you know, whatever. So I'm gonna turn her around. And then, so this will be like my forehead. So I just want to kind of pull it forward a little bit. And I'm going to find the back portion, the back of the frontal. And so I just glued, I just pinned down the very middle. And so I'm gonna pin down the middle back here first. And then I'm gonna go to the sides. And so you wanna make this part flat and then everything else is gonna be kind of bunched up, but whenever you put it onto your head, it's gonna actually fit better. So I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna line it. And so what it's gonna do is it's gonna kind of bring this down. So as you can see, it's flat. Then you're gonna do the same on the other side. So this is how it's going to look in the front. And so first step is just to go ahead and sew that down. Okay guys, I forgot to show you, but you will need some thread. This is just nylon thread that I got from Amazon. I will link the link to this below. And then I have just two large needles that I really like using for my wigs making. I used to have more than these. I don't know where they went because I used to just pre-make them and just have them setting and ready for me, but I don't know where it is, so we're just gonna use it too. Probably should use blonde thread, but I don't have blonde thread, so you know, you gotta use what you got. It'll be alright. And I'm okay with leaving little gaps in between my frontals because whenever I go on and sew my tracks, I'm gonna connect the tracks to the actual frontal, so it'll actually, whatever little space is not sewn will actually get sewn down eventually. So no need to worry about that, guys. Hey guys,
your girl is freaking exhausted. Oh, I'm tired. Excuse my edges. I been wearing a wig using the Gatsby glue spray, so edge is real crusty right now, but just look past that and we'll be all right. So I just finished this wig. I'm about to try it on for the first time and we're gonna see how it looks. Okay, so this is the wig. The frontal, I'm gonna just pull the frontal back and we're gonna cut this stocking cap. Gosh, it fits so good. And honestly, I don't even know if I'm gonna do anything with these edges. I just do the this part because this is too much into the forehead. I gotta pull it forward because I got the wheels or the whatever these cowlicks. But I can technically wear this glueless. Like the wig is really, it's flat, it's just poofy. Okay. What y'all thinking? I like it, it's cute. So like I said, I always start doing stuff and I forget to record for y'all, or I might have said it in my mind, I don't know. But I'm just working on my hairline right now. Trying to get it to look a little bit better. Because I kind of have like a widow's peak and the hairline came like straight here. And obviously my forehead ain't that small. And I have the hair pulled forward enough so that I can cover my actual hair. So what I did, I'm just show y'all how I'm actually like tweezing this, and I'm not even really tweezing it. Since this is hair that I'm know for sure that I'm not going to keep, I'm going to actually tweeze this part up here, like customize this part, but this is actually coming off. So I did wet it just a little bit and I just get my hair retied tomorrow. And then, oh, by the way guys, I am officially 3 months locked today. So it's like actually pulling them out from the very root, the knot or whatever. And so this matches my hairline a little bit better. Just a little bit. And I cut some bangs. So this light, this ring light doesn't really just do this hair any like justice, because it, y'all see that? Anybody got time to be rewashing no hair? So, so this is how my hair is gonna be while I'm in Bali. Cute or whatever, you know, just a little bit something. I'm gonna keep this on until I glue it down. I'm trying to see if I want to do the stocking cap method. Since I am gonna be retying my hair tomorrow, like getting my hair redone, my locks. I don't wanna, so the product buildup, it really isn't, that's a whole different video. Let me not even go into that, but I'm gonna think about it. I need a darker cap because the light cap, I need some contrast in this part. But yeah, it's a lot flatter than yesterday, if y'all, like, than the first time I showed y'all this hair. I'm gonna just show y'all how I'm gonna do the roots real quick, because I don't have time to actually go through and re-dye everything. And then this will kind of actually help with, like, the flyaways. But this is just some Anastasia Beverly Hills, some brow gel, and, like, what color is this? Espresso. Since the roots are already kind of this color, I'm gonna just go in and kind of define them a little bit more, because some areas are a little bit lighter than the other. And it's only gonna be where I'm having a part, because I don't plan on parting this wig too much. Secure the lace, ladies. Secure the wig.
Okay, guys, so the wig is done, it's on, it's not going nowhere, and it's gonna stay for a while. So I hope you all enjoyed this video. It's gonna be super long, two parts, so please bear with me. Hold on a second. Another video is gonna come with a review on this hair because I've never used. So this is gonna be actually like a little bit of a series type of video. The first one is just me coloring it, and then the next video is me actually constructing the wig. Because I don't think I've actually done an updated wig video. It's been years, like at least another, like at least a year since I've done a video where I made a wig. And even when I did make that one, I don't know. Anyways, so there's gonna be that video, and then there's gonna be the video of me just giving a review on this hair. I do wanna actually give a review on this hair just because I've never had 613 hair before. Or, wait, I'm lying. I have had 613 hair before. I have not had this 613 hair. So I actually bought this, and then I got another set of bundles and frontal from the same company, 613 hair, just in a different texture, or a different pattern. So the video is gonna come on me, or the video is gonna be of me talking about this hair and that hair whenever I get to wear it. So it's gonna be a little bit later, obviously, because I'm about to be wearing this wig and I'm not gonna be wearing the other one, and I haven't even made the other one, so you know. But I hope you all enjoy the videos. Like, comment, subscribe, comment anything that y'all might want to see, or you know, just like the video. But anyways, yeah, so this is the hair. I think it came out beautifully. Hairline is really natural. I just really need to work on like the lace part of it. But I think what I messed up doing was putting powder on the lace, because it was transparent. I should have just let it be, but like it would have melted in. But you live and you learn, guys. So yeah, this is it. Give you a 360s, real long. I did cut some layers in it that I'm gonna eventually curl. But goes down to my booty. So yeah, thank you all for watching, guys. See you later.